Blessed are you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth. You have revealed to the little ones the mysteries of your kingdom.
My brothers and my sisters, the Lord is with you. Reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus explained to them, I myself am the bread of life. No one who comes to me shall ever be hungry. No one who believes in me shall ever thirst. But as I told you, though you have seen me, you still do not believe. All that the Father gives me shall come to me. No one who comes will I ever reject, because it is not to do my own will that I have come down from heaven, but to do the will of him who sent me. The Gospel of the Lord.
Girls, what are we doing here today? What are we doing here today? We're receiving Jesus into our hearts. What is this, what we call this? First what? First communion. And if you look around, you'll see the church is full. The people that are here, just because it's your first communion day. That's the only reason they're here. They're here because this, right now, is the most important day in your life so far. Now, when you were born, you had another important day. Can you tell me what that day is? What was that day, that other important day? Your baptism day. And in that baptism day, you were baptized into whose family? God's family. And if you have little ones at home, little brothers and sisters, or if you remember when you were a baby, when you ate, you didn't eat from the table right away, did you? What did you eat first? Baby food? Before that, you ate milk, right? Drank milk. And the reason you did this, why? Why didn't you just sit right at the table and eat food? I'm sorry, what? You didn't know, and you weren't old enough, and you weren't ready for it, right? You weren't ready to eat regular table food. And it's the same way in the family of God. Today is your first communion day. Today is the first day you're going to eat from the God's table, which is the altar. And you'll receive the body of Christ from God's table. So today we say to you, now you're old enough to come to the table with all of us and to eat of the bread of life. That's another name we call Jesus, the bread of life. That's what he told us in the Gospels, that he was the bread of life. He would feed us. And we know that we are made up of body and what? Body and what? No, we're made up of body and blood, but body and what? What am I looking for? What word? Soul. We're made up of, I'm sorry, I missed you. We're made up of body and soul. And when your parents feed you at home, they are feeding you food to nourish your bodies. And the reason you eat is why? Why do you eat? Why do you eat meat and vegetables? What?
So, and then you can like...
Why do you eat?
So you can grow.
So you can grow strong, right? And that's why we partake of the bread of life, so that our souls will grow strong and healthy, just like our bodies, okay? And that's why today, for the first time, you eat of the body of Christ. And we hope that you will do this often. We hope you will do this every time you come to church, that you'll partake of the body of Christ, because just like you know you have to eat your meals every day, so you have to partake of the body of Christ to nourish your souls. Okay? Does everybody understand that? And what do we say? It's the most important day in your life so far, because you're going to partake of this bread of life, of this body of Christ. Okay? Now, I'd just like to talk to your parents for a minute. So if you can sit quietly for a little bit. I'm just going to talk to them for a short time. It won't take long, all right? Very good. We talk about the sacrament of baptism. And in the sacrament of baptism, the fathers receive a blessing. And in that blessing, the mothers and the fathers are told, may you be the best of teachers in the ways of faith for your children. May you be the best of teachers and the first of teachers. Look at how excited and thrilled these children are today. They are so happy to be doing what they are doing, and they have been instilled with this because of the fine lessons that their teachers have given them. They have instilled in them this great desire to receive communion. And now it is up to you to fuel that desire. It is up to you to continue the nourishment that today they will receive for the first time. It is up to you to see to it that they continue to be thrilled and excited over what they are doing today. Every week they come here, as you come here with them, to be nourished at the table of the Lord. And if you do this regularly, if you do this with excitement yourself, if you let them know that you too are thrilled to be doing what they are doing for the first time today, then they will always have the same happiness, the same thrill that they feel today. They know today, Jesus told us, the little children teach us. They today teach us by their thrill, by the thrill that they feel, what an important moment it is for us. And each week, we have that opportunity. We can give that opportunity again to these children. It is up to us to continue to do so. So this morning, or rather this afternoon now, I congratulate all of you on this wonderful occasion. And I hope that for the rest of your lives, when you come to church, you will feel as thrilled and excited as you do today. May God love and bless you all.
We believe in one God.
Heavenly Father, we thank you for bringing us together today so that we can receive your Son, Jesus, for the first time. We pray now and ask these prayers. That all of us and all of our followers will be sincere in our Christian life. That when we break bread and receive this Eucharist, we'll show in our lives our faith in Christ. We pray to the Lord. That we may always be thankful for the gift of God's Son, we pray to the Lord.
Thank you.
dog, the first reading class is bringing up a footprint to symbolize that we are all followers of Jesus. A butterfly to symbolize our new life in Jesus Christ. A Bible to remind us of all the stories we have heard about Jesus and how he loves us. And a candle to remind us that Jesus is the light of the world.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. For your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made, will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. For your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become for us our spiritual drink. Lord God, we ask you to receive us, and to be pleased with the sacrifice we offer you with humble and contrite hearts. Lord, wash away my iniquities. Cleanse me from my sins. My brothers and sisters, pray that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty. Lord God, by this holy exchange of gifts, you share with us your divine life. Grant that everything we do may be directed by the knowledge of your truth. We ask this in the name of Jesus, the Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Father, all-powerful and ever-living God, we do well always and everywhere to give you thanks through Jesus Christ, our Lord. We praise you with greater joy than ever in this Easter season, when Christ became our paschal sacrifice. As he offered his body on the cross, his perfect sacrifice fulfilled all others. As he gave himself into your hands for our salvation, he showed himself to be the priest, the altar, and the lamb of sacrifice. The joy of the resurrection renews the whole world, while the choirs of heaven sing forever to your glory.
Thank you.
Yes, Lord, you are holy. You are kind to us and to all. For this we thank you. We thank you above all for your Son, Jesus Christ. He brought us the good news of life to be lived with you forever in heaven. He showed us the way to that life, the way of love. He himself has gone that way before us. He now brings us together to one table and asks us to do what he did. Father, we ask you to bless these gifts of bread and wine and make them holy. Change them for us into the body and blood of Jesus Christ, your Son. On the night before he died for us, he had supper for the last time with his disciples. He took bread and gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his friends, and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In the same way, he took a cup of wine. He gave you thanks and handed the cup to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all, so that sins may be forgiven." Then he said to them, "Do this in memory of me."
Let us proclaim the mystery of faith.
Our sins, and to bring us to forgive those who sin against us.